I was
actually previously married. Was going through a pretty ugly divorce, child custody battle. Went through some things that caused me to lose my job. I lost a 10-year career, and I was just in a very, very low place at the time. And we came together at a point where I just needed someone in my life that could really be there for me, to support me at a time where there was just nothing there. I felt like I was in a place of darkness, surrounded in darkness. And I felt like God sent her to me as a shining light in a dark place. And so while going through this, she stood by me, supported me. I really didn't even understand why she was there, to be honest with you. Because, I mean, I've never really had many people in my life that just wanted to be there for no other reason other than to be there. No ulterior motives, just to be there, just to make sure I was okay. And for her, the one thing that she did tell me that always has stuck with me is that all she wants is for me to be happy. Awesome. Everything about what we're doing is about the happiness that we have, and all she stayed true to that. The entire time we've been together, I can honestly say that this is a lady that has just stood with me to make sure that I'm happy. She's my backbone. When times are tough, everything falling apart, I mean, I was at a point of being swayed, going another direction, even in my career. Her quote was, "Is this what you want to do? Do you feel that you'd be successful doing it? Then that's what you do. I got you. Till we get there, I got you." So, at this point,
okay. Well, now the next question. You know the next question, right? You want to take a guess what the next question is?
What's that?
I want you to go back to that first kiss, that very first kiss.
That was as soon as I met him, honey.
Oh, was it? Oh,
I
man.
I talked to him for 4 months. I mean, when I picked the man, I just went out and wanted to touch the lips.
You went
up. Did y'all see him? Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, he's very cute. I had to go on kiss them lips. Ian has this. He is so lovely. Ian is like a teddy bear to me. He, on the inside, he's like this teddy bear. And on the outside, he has this rough, you know, alpha male personality. But at the end of the day, it's just me and him. He's like this soft little teddy bear that. And, I'm gonna tell you what I love about this man more than anything, and I hope I can't wait till you see it. I don't even think of.
You got it now.
I don't think I've ever even said this, but the strangest thing to me was letting. Was Ian always wanted me to hug him, and I mean always wanted me close to him. Men aren't always as affectionate as Ian is, and he just loves me close to him. I love that. What are we looking for?
They talk about they can't find the dress.
Who dress?
Your baby dress. They at the house.
Who is that?
Alaya.
Okay, I need to.
Okay.
Hold on.
Yeah. And we were introduced to a mutual friend, Valley Newman, and we talked on the phone. We didn't want to see each other. I just wanted to know if this was going to be something that was real. So we talked on the phone for 3-4 months before we even shared a photo or saw each other. Once we actually did, I was like, okay, that's a nice picture, now send me a real one. And she was like, that is me. And I was like, okay, well, now I really got to meet you then. So we made it happen pretty quickly after that. And we had a real good time. I mean, the first time we met, we actually met at Dave & Buster's. My mother was there, my brother was there. I won't even say my sister was there and a couple of other friends. And I mean, we just had a great time, man. Everybody just kind of hung out. We played some games. Me and her were there first, of course. We had a couple of drinks and just kind of kicked it, man. And everything meshed well. And I mean, honestly speaking, it was love before first sight. But at first sight, it was definitely love.
Awesome. Yeah. That sounds good. That's a great story. And it kind of sounds exactly like the story we got from her. And then the last question that I did ask her was the first kiss. Do you remember the first kiss? And what were you thinking at that point?
Hey, man, you put me on the spot on that one. First kiss. We had a lot of kisses. First kiss. Man, you want to cut that one. What was the first kiss? Man, I'm a man, dude. I mean, you know, I was looking beyond the kiss. first kiss. Man, I didn't study for that one. What was her answer on that?
She said it was pretty quick. She said it happened pretty...
Well, it was quick. I'm trying to think of where it was at. Because, I mean, once we seen each other, we had a whole lot of kisses. I can't remember exactly where that first one was at.
That's all right. You've had plenty since, so.
Yeah, we've had a whole lot of them since then. But I do know that, you know, when we shared that first kiss, I do remember that it was dynamite, man. It was just, it was really real. We had a real connection, a spiritual connection. I mean, of course, there was a physical connection, but I know that through the series of the kisses and the moments that we shared, we've shared a real spiritual connection. Even beyond the physical, and when we kiss, we touch each other, we hold each other. I mean, the feelings are real. I mean, the.
Getting here, I'm about to go put my dress on. Fixing to be me.
Is there anybody in particular you're thinking about? In particular, one person?
I had to name one person. It would be my mom.
Your mom. And you know that she's with us today, even though. She may not be with us in body, she's definitely here with us in spirit. Do you sometimes, can you feel that presence?
I'm about to test this makeup. Yeah, I do.
Tell me a little bit about your mom, because I had never got a chance to meet her, but. But
you are doing a whole lot for me right now. Mom was a real fun person. She loved everybody. And she was my friend. Like, I could talk to her about anything. Right now, I'll probably be able to call her and just say everything that's going on in my mind. Nobody else could tell me anything to calm down. She would be able to say just what I needed to hear. And you probably wouldn't even be able to understand it, because it would be so in her country vernacular that nobody would know it but me. I really didn't even want to do a wedding, because she couldn't be here. And I don't want to.
But you know she is here though, Ericka.
I don't want to take away from anybody that is able to be here. It just would have meant the world to me to have my mama see me today.
Yeah, she's definitely here with us. That's for sure.
Yeah.
And I love that picture that they have. I don't know who made that for you, but it is very nice.
Sister had that made for me for a gift. That's my wedding gift.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah, it was a great gift. So she is probably the one other person in the world that can truly say, that I can say, knows exactly how I'm feeling. Me and my sister spent 16 days in a hospice facility with my mom before she died. Though she's always been my sister, she's been around all the time, and she was my little sister, annoying the hell out of me growing up. But it was at that moment that we had some sort of bond that just grew, watching my mama leave this world. That was it.
Thank you. Let's pray. Lord God, we thank you for this time. Thank you for bringing us this far. Thank you for your loving kindness and tender mercy. Thank you for being better to us than we've been to ourselves. We give you all the glory and honor for what's being done and what's going to be done. Thank you for the honor and Ericka. Bless you for your blessing and your presence in this ceremony. Bless the remainder of this ceremony in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible said, lo, children are a heritage to the Lord, of the Lord. And it is our fathers that cause us to be so. But it's our mothers that bring us into the world. Because of that, Sister Linda Magruder is not able to be here with us in her physical presence. But we know she's here in spirit. This time we want to light a memorial candle in honor of her legacy. Together here in the sight of God and in the presence of this company to join together this man and this woman in the holy estate of matrimony, which is commended of St. Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently discreetly and advisedly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. If any man can show just cause, while they may not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever hold his peace. I require and charge you both that you will answer the dreadful day of judgment, and all the secrets of heart shall be disclosed, that if either of you know of any impediment, or you may not lawfully be joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise than God's law doth allow, their marriage is not valid. Brother Eon Tremaine Robbs, wilt thou have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance, the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaken all others, keep thee only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Sister Ericka Patrice Jones, wilt thou have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou obey him and serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaken all others, keep thee only unto him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Who giveth this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Step forward, please. The Bible said that marriage is honorable in all things. Yet in today's society, marriage is not always honorable. It's often ridiculed and viewed as an institution of the past, but in God's eyesight, marriage is honorable. The Bible said that God looked down and saw Adam and said, it's not good for man to be all one, not good for man to be alone. So God caused the deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and from Adam's own side, God took Eve. Took her from his side that she may walk beside him at all times, from beside his heart that he may love and cherish her, from above his feet that he may never walk upon her. Thus Eve became flesh of his flesh and bone of his bone. Wherever he lodges, thou shalt lodge. Wherever he goeth, thou shalt go. His people shall be thy people, and thy people shall be his people. For he shall die, you will die. For he will be buried, you will be buried. Thus the Bible said that whatsoever God hath put together, let no man put asunder. How can you be sure that you'll have a successful marriage? There are three characteristics that are prevalent in every successful marriage. Number one, Christ must be the head of the home. Number two, the husband must love his wife as his own flesh. And number three, the wife must submit to the husband as unto the Lord. If these three solemn vows are kept inviolate, you can be sure that you will have a successful marriage. Brother Eon Tremaine Riles, repeat behind me, please. I, Eon Tremaine Riles.
I, Eon Tremaine Riles.
Take thee, Ericka Patrice Jones.
Take thee, Ericka Patrice Jones.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer and for poor.
For richer and for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
And thereto I pledge thee my troth.
And thereto I pledge thee my troth.
Sister Jones, will you repeat behind me? I, Ericka Patrice Jones.
I, Ericka Patrice Jones.
Take thee, Eon Tremaine Riles.
Take thee, Eon Tremaine Riles.
Tremaine
Brown. Okay.
You want a man, the right man.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
Yeah. To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer and for poor.
For richer and for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
To cherish.
To cherish.
And to obey.
And to obey.
Till death do us part.
Death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
The rings, please. Thank you. Let's pray. God, we thank you for this part of the ceremony where we exchange giving of rings. The ring represents the undying circle of love. And we'll forever remind them of the night that they pledged their love and vows each to the other. I pray for that symbol of the ring. I give you glory, honor, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Eon Tremaine, she take rings and place them upon Sister Jones's finger and repeat behind me, please.
Turn this way here.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods.
With all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Sister Jones, you take this ring, please. Place it upon Eon's finger and repeat behind me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods.
And with all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
Place it. Turn, face me, and join right hands again. Close the gap. It is our honor and privilege to be here tonight because two halves have just become one whole. The Bible says here to find a wife, find a good thing. So at this time, we want to light the unity candle to unite the two families.
Saving forever for you.
Thank you.
you.
For as much as Brother Eon Tremaine Riles and Sister Ericka Patrice Jones have consented together in holy wedlock, have witnessed the same before God and this company, and hereto have given and pledged their troth each to the other, and have declared the same by the giving and receiving of a ring, by joining of hands, I pronounce that they are man and wife in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ forever. Therefore, what the Lord have joined together, let no man put asunder. You may salute your bride. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Eon Tremaine Riles.
Thank you. Make some noise out there, you guys. Mr. and Mrs. Ian and Ericka Rouse tonight. Oh yeah, get your cameras out. Gonna make it a family affair tonight.
Thank you.
another round of applause, you guys, right there.
I want to thank Valerie Newman for introducing us, because without her making that connection, that wouldn't have taken place. And that's just the connection. Beyond that, man, I want to thank God for just keeping me, providing for me, making a way for us to be able to come together and make this thing happen, man. I mean, this is definitely a God-ordained, a God-appointed meeting between the two of us. And she was supposed to be in my life. She's destined to be in my life. God built her and purposed her just for me. And I know that and I believe that. And all the things, the negatives that I've been through, as well as the positives, and as well as the negatives and the positives that she's experienced in her life, were all in preparation for us to be where we are today. And I'm excited about it, and I look forward to spending the rest of my life with her. I love you, Ericka Jones.